Hello and welcome to this video where we'll be flashing and setting up the pixhawk as if it was the first time. So the first thing you're going to do is just plug in the pixhawk through this USB cable that comes with it, like that, and you see it lights up. Then you need to go to your computer and you need to install firmware up here. So now it is just connecting right there and it receives the list, and whichever airframe that you're using, you should click here. And as we're using a quadcopter, so go ahead and click the autocopter, and it says if you're sure, and yes you are. Okay, so now it says please unplug the board, then press OK and plug it back in. So unplug the board and press OK and plug the board back in. Now it's going to look for the board and see if it can find it, and now it says erase, so now it's erasing the previous version of the autocopter on this, and now it is installing the new version. So it says upload done, and just wait until the musical tones stop, and when they stop you press OK. And we can now connect it up and see if this is actually we're actually getting any information. Connecting the pixhawk, that's just done. Just going to get right. So go into the flight data, and as you can see here, if I move this about, you see the diagram move around. So we have actually connected up and flash this with a new firmware. So go into the initial setup again and go into the mandatory hardware and go into accelerometer calibration, because we're going to calibrate the accelerometer now. Okay, so level up your aircraft and it says press any key. Okay, so now it says place vehicle on its left side. So the front is this way, so its left side is this over here, so we're going to place it right here and press any key. Place it on the right side, place the vehicle nose down, and place the vehicle nose up. Place the vehicle on its back. Calibration successful. Compass calibration now. So go ahead and click the compass calibration. I'm not gonna show you on camera because it's difficult, but just go ahead and click compass calibration and click the orientation for the pixhawk/px4 on the screen and press live calibration. And it says, it comes with an alert box. It says, please click OK and move the autopilot around in all axes in a circular motion. So press OK, and what you're going to do is you're going to move this around all the axes that you can, and when it says it is done, you press OK. And you can see on the flight data page that if you move the pixhawk around, the GPS will sense that the new orientation, or the magnetometer will sense the new orientation, and it will actually point in the right direction, as you can see there. Okay, so you want to go ahead and connect up a battery, and preferably connect up the telemetry module instead of the USB. It makes it a bit more for calibration, easier for calibration. So connect up a battery and turn on your radio, because we're now going to do radio calibration here. And on your radio, you want to make sure that nothing is preset. You don't want to have any exponentials, you don't want to have any reverse, and you want to have no rate. You don't want to be completely stuck for setting up here. So go ahead and click the calibrate radio. Ensure your transmitter is on and the receiver is powered. Ensure your motor does not have power/props. So yes, you don't want to have any props on this, but we didn't mount any either. So go ahead and click OK. and move all the switches to the extreme positions, so the red bars hit the limit. So okay, so you want to move the sticks around as much as you can until you see the red bars moves to the extremes of your controls, and then go ahead and move the switches, every one of the switches that you can, so it gets to the extreme. Even the potentiometers, if those do anything in your radio. So once that has been done, go ahead and click OK, or click when done. Ensure all your sticks are centered and throttle is down, and click OK to continue. So you want all your sticks to, all your sticks to be centered, so which means this and the rudder, and the throttle should be down, and all your switches should be turned off, and click OK. And says completed, and it's saving. And here is the radio values that it detected, which is just the minimum and maximum value it detected, and just click OK. So that is the radio calibrated, and we can go into the optional hardware over here and take the battery monitor, because I'm only going to fly with one battery, which is a 6,000 mAh battery. So I'm gonna go ahead and connect that up, and depending on which power module you have, I'm just gonna go ahead and click the 3DR power module, and I have the pixhawk and voltage and current. So you can get an alert on low voltage, and just say okay. So what do you want to warn at? So you can just set this, and if you say that 3.7 volts is the minimum for your battery, the battery minimum will be 14.8 volts. I'm gonna set it a bit lower to 3.5, just to get a little bit more flight time, but still be able to be safe and protect the battery. So I'm gonna go ahead and click 14 volts, because 3.5 times 4 is 14, and click OK. And what percentage do you want to warn at? Click 15% and click OK. Yeah, this is basically it. So now we're gonna go ahead and fly and see how it is.